Hello, hello, good morning. We are live. Happy Thanksgiving. I'm streaming today because I want to. And, you know, in countries that are not the United States, it is not Thanksgiving Day. So, it's time to play some video games. Now, if you look at the stream title, that is a little bit of play on words. I did want to wish people a happy Thanksgiving, but also I'm going to be playing hardcore mode, and happy hardcore is kind of a subgenre of music that I sometimes enjoy. So it's just kind of a funny little joke. We're going to continue with our hardcore character. She is level 10, almost 11, and we are going to just see how far we can get today, hopefully without dying. We'll find out. Dying is not allowed. Then we'd have to start all the way over, and I don't feel like doing that today. So we're going to have some fun. I got myself 95% opacity in the corner just so I can see my loot drops. Might get a little annoying, but we'll see how that goes. And I'm wearing my glasses because I fell asleep with my contacts in, and I can't put them back in because my eyeballs hurt. So that's the current situation. We have several projects. A lot of them are complete activities, and we've got to collect caches in Southwest. Let's just see where we are with things map-wise. Not going to venture to get that safe house. That's incredibly dangerous because it's a level 25 zone, and it's very easy to die, even just going from here to there. Now, I could be, you know, really brave and just go do it, but I'm not gonna. Don't need to worry about these side missions. We did not take MLK Library or Red Dragon, so we might want to clear this neighborhood just to warm up before we continue on. Maybe try to get ourselves to level 11 and then grab some new loot, check the vendors, and then we will look at the next mission. I think the next mission is for level 12, so we might be a little ahead of the curve here. We've got our turret, we've got our drone, we've got a nice assault rifle. Let's do some work. Blinded. Turret's getting headshots while I'm blind. Get him. I'm hanging back a little bit because I know the next wave. Oh, it's right here. Look at that. What's up, guys? I knew it spawned somewhere. I mean, obviously it spawned somewhere. I meant it spawned somewhere nearby. Did not expect it to spawn directly next to me. So that was a nice little surprise. All right, we're fine. Everything's fine. E and a crappy gun. And gloves that I don't want. Cool. All right, now we can take the control point, which appears to be in conflict already. By no fault of mine. Somebody's shooting at him. All right. Now, for MLK Library, I like to camp out up here. And there are a couple different ways you could do it. This tree, unfortunately, is right in the way. Otherwise, this would be a perfect spot. But you get a nice vantage from here for most of the control points. And the defend waves are even easier because you essentially just go on that catwalk that I'm aiming at. And you can see everything from up there, and it's really difficult for anybody to actually get to you. So that's typically what I do for the defend wave. But each of these control points has several different strategies you can employ depending on how you want to do them. And they vary in size too. Like once I get over in the west side of the map and I'm doing stuff like the gas station and that sort of thing. Some of the control points are just huge, and they're a lot of area to cover and manage, especially by yourself. So, no big deal, though. That's an elite grenader, and he's just about dead, so we're just going to run and run in, because there we go. Red bars. There we go. All right. Getting some headshots today. Where's my rope? Gotta go past it. There it is. Grab the rope. Get up on the catwalk. Toss out the turret. And let's do some business here. Could have and should have probably checked vendors before I started warming up, but it really doesn't matter. You know, talking about slight advantages, maybe a slightly better gun. It's always best to check vendors just after you level up, though. That's the ideal time. But we're going to get loot and check the vendors, because level 11 is here. There we go. Didn't take long. I was right there on the edge, so cool. Excellent. All right. Oh, and I figured out the audio issue where the game's not playing audio cues and different stuff. It just has to do with the audio setup that I have. The PlayStation doesn't actually isn't set up to. Yeah, I had to mute my stuff. It's not outputting properly. It's really strange. But it is, it's a slight bug, and I'm just going to leave it alone because I don't care. It's fine. All right. We don't need to worry about this control point officer, right? Probably not. I know we got to donate gloves. There we go. That's what I was looking for. All right. Complete activities in East Mall, which is here, which can include these control points. Control points are an activity. But since we just hit level 11, let's grab some loot and check the vendors. I feel like we're pretty warmed up. We could go take Red Dragon. We could. Maybe we will. And fully liberate the neighborhood. Got some coffee here. The last of my coffee with caffeine in it. I have decaf for later. Going to be making some Irish coffee. Not the greatest thing to do with regular coffee if it's, you know, 5-6 p.m. unless you really feel like staying up till 3 in the morning. Intentionally or unintentionally. I often have trouble sleeping when I consume caffeine in the dark. In the dark hours. All right. Crappy backpack, but, you know, that's good. It's good things are moving right along. All loot is good loot when you're in hardcore, I guess. When you're level 11, all loot's good loot. That's for sure. So we're just doing the same loot route as before. Again, these chests respawn or repopulate every 24 hours. So anywhere you see chests on the overworld map, they'll be there again the next day. Ooh, purple submachine gun. I marked it as trash because I'm always so eager to mark things as trash. Once again, it's messed up my sort settings, so we gotta set that properly. Oh, look at that. We got police M4. It's level 8. We don't want that. Yeah, I'd rather use an MP5 than an MG5. Huh. That's kind of funny. Probably don't need an ACOG scope on it, but, you know, it'll work. Let's go fancy skin. Because this is blue? I guess it's blue. allows us to put skins on it. We'll just throw some stuff on. It's no big deal. At least we got a grip we can put on it. Not very many mods, obviously, because still very low level. I have a level 9 assault rifle. All right, let's keep going. Let's just keep going. We'll do our inventory management back at the base. I'm just messing around. All right. Look at that MP5. Makes me feel like Steven Seagal in Under Siege. This is the MP5. It's got a selector switch. One option is automatic, one is semi-automatic. That's the one I'm gonna give you. I want you to spend one round at a time. That's my Steven Seagal voice. It's not great. I didn't practice it. Can you tell? That's a classic movie, though. The second one's a classic, too, but in a totally different way. If you've never seen the Under Siege movies, you need to do yourself a favor. Pay whatever bullshit rental fee that Amazon charges you and watch both of them immediately. They are horribly cheesy 90s action entertainment. So good. Cereals. Trash ninjas. I ain't afeard of them. Alright. Well, they dropped something for me. That was nice. Thanks, trash ninjas. Oh, it's a holster. Everybody loves holsters. Oh, you know what? I think I'm still too opaque. I'm gonna have to adjust my opacity so that I can actually see my loot drops. I think last time I did it at 85%, right now it's at 95%, and I don't look as ghostly, but I also can't read what I'm picking up. Yeah, modular holster, there you go. A lot of holsters. Oh, there's somebody else nearby. Wow. Pistol jumped 4 levels. Who's coming after me here? Oh, okay. It's a hammer, bro. An outcast heavy. I will kill him real quick because he is almost guaranteed to drop something. Because he's an elite. Here we go. Oh, with a max roll on it. On crappy submachine gun. But A, it's purple. And B, it has a talent. Woo. Look at that. Awesome. Wait, it's level 9? No, we're not going to use the level 9. We will throw that talent in the recalibration library in case we want to use it. I think that's what we ought to do. All right, keep going, loot route. Keep going. We're not even making any progress right now. We're just getting better stuff. Or trying to get better stuff. This is still technically part of the warm-up, you know? Almost every time I start one of these sessions, my gun just disappeared. Those sentences weren't related, but... Okay, it's back now. That's very strange. All right. But every time I start one of these sessions, especially if I just level up, always a good idea to grab loot. You know, always try to keep your loot current. Gives you a huge advantage. Now, I have noticed, because I get shot so much, it might be a good idea for me to have an armor piece or two. I don't really normally play that way, but since we're on hardcore, really not a bad idea. I mean, I've made it this far without it, without intentionally picking up pieces with armor rolls. But I do feel like I get shot a lot, and I don't want to die. So armor's not a terrible idea. We'll take a look. We'll see what our options are. Another MP5. Okay, well, there's some loot. Let's go check the vendors. keeps wanting me to talk to the pilot. Skip to New York. I can't even skip to New York. So here, I'll waste a second talking to the pilot to be told, oh, you can't boost to NYC. Oh, okay, thanks, game. Stop telling me to do that. Bloody hell. All right. Now, first up, let's see what we got out of here. What's a blue cache? A C-tar. All right, that'll work. That'll work. I will take it. Definitely don't need that. No, it's got a really poor mod setup. But that's okay. At least it can take a weapon skin. All right, what else we got? Oh, I got a mod. Oh boy, a skill mod. Oh, and actually a useful skill mod. Amazing. That's amazing. All right, so DNA, nah, we don't need that. Oh, nice. Awesome. All right, for sure. Don't need any of those. Nope, and nope. Although that would be an armor piece. That's a tough sell. I might switch to this, actually. That's fine. We're relying on our skills a lot. So having 3-4 skill tiers, wow. Let's see. Yeah, these are fine. And knee pads. I'm using level 5 knee pads. I guess I can upgrade. That's fine. All right. Maybe I should do an armor piece. Yeah. What the hell? I don't need 4 skill tiers. Having a little bit of extra armor will pay off. All right, let's see what we can do here. I don't think I get recalibration yet, actually. No, definitely not. Okay, soon though. So I'm gonna hang on to that gun just in case it becomes useful. Got nothing that needs to be donated, so I'm just gonna sell all this crap. No, not trinkets. Just the junk, please. Just the junk. All right. What does this guy have for me? Ooh, a high-end named item. Too bad it's a crappy gun. Although P90s are cool. I miss P90 in Counter-Strike. I love the P90. Check out that RPM. All right. Must, but it's green. Yeah, none of this stuff is worth buying. All right, let's check the clan vendor. And I'm sure I said it last time, but that's a big tip for hardcore mode. Be in a clan, because having this additional vendor is a big help some of the time. That was a purple ACS-12. Yeah, not this time, unfortunately. Although these gloves wouldn't be too bad of an investment. Nothing good. Nothing good. All right. Well, nice try anyway. Let's adjust my opacity real quick. All right, that's a bit better. We'll go down to 75 if we need to. I can kind of see words. Maybe we should go down to 75, or maybe we should just go down to 80. Ah, that's better. All right, we'll try 80 for a while. Cool. All right. So, next missions are down here. Level 12 and 14. So we probably want to try to get to 12. We don't have to. I mean, we could definitely do Jefferson Plaza on at level 11. But we don't have to. Let's try and get some more loot. Let's do Red Dragon. Because that's a pretty fun control point. A couple different ways to do it. We want to... head east and then north from MLK. And obviously when you head east from MLK, you gotta watch out for the stronghold, which is just up the street. District Union Arena is the hyena stronghold. There's gonna be level 25 enemies there. And they will kill me. So I'm gonna leave that alone and just head for the control point. I also have to be careful not to venture into this neighborhood. Same reason. And it's going to be just right there. So, got to be very careful. Don't shoot at anything in the level 25 neighborhood on accident or on purpose. And actually, I'm going to do something really dangerous, but I'm going to set my skills... because I want to use Seeker Mines again. Especially now that I got a mod for +1 Seeker Mines. Super useful. So I have 7 mines. They're going to do a ton of damage. It's going to be great. You'll see. I just have to be really careful not to get blown up by my own Seeker Mines, which absolutely happens, especially when you have, you know, when you're up against rushers, you know, hyena rushers and outcast rushers, they'll just run right at you. At least the True Sons rushers they have guns, you know. All right, here we go. Nice. All right, we're gonna get a C-tar. This thing is so hard to control. Crazy rate of fire. All right, who else? Oh, I thought I put my drone out. I guess I did not. Get him, droney. I haven't said that in a while. Show moose bucks. Get them fireworks. Like the 4th of July. It's the wrong holiday. It's Thanksgiving, so. Wrong holiday. Then again, most American holidays are the same. Overeat and get drunk. That's quote-unquote celebrating. Not that I'm complaining. It's the way we celebrate around here. Now, what's one cool thing about this control point is you can get up in this building. If you really want to play defensively, you can chill up here. You're not invincible by any means, but you can chill up here. Oh, and that was all of them. You gotta be careful, though, because I think sometimes enemies spawn from in there. Yeah, you don't want to be there when that happens. Okay. Get him. I was trying to go for drug bag. Damn it. What the? All right. We're good. All set. All right, that didn't take long. Damn it. Wrong button. All right. We're fine. 50-second cooldown on those Seeker Mines. That is nuts. All right. Crap and crap and crap. Cool, cool. So I mentioned that the chests respawn every day. The thing to also keep in mind in hardcore mode is with the vendors, their stock will change at least somewhat slightly. Obviously, every week it changes because that's just a natural cycle of the game. But as you level up, their stock will change as well just because more items become available in the loot pool, which is kind of, I don't know. So you might find it strange, but it's just one of the ways this game operates. So let's do some activities. We're going to finish off this project in East Mall. It's going to be this one. And then we got to do activities in Federal Triangle, which is here. Maybe we'll do that first. I do not want to do supply drop. Not a fan. So let's do this activity because that's just going to be a propaganda broadcast. Got to do. Let's just finish out these two projects and we'll see if we get to level 12. Coffee's getting cold. Might have to heat that up. It is my last caffeinated coffee. Like I mentioned earlier, I have decaf, but that's not what I need right now. It's 8:21 in the morning. You know? Admittedly, I've been awake for like 3-ish hours, so it's not a huge deal. I'm not like desperate for caffeine. And if I do get desperate for caffeine, I've got green tea. Yeah, look at all those red marks on the minimap. There's stuff everywhere. Oh, it's a public execution. Okay. It's fine. Either way, it's fine. These guys don't have a chance. Oh, that's the hostage. Don't shoot the hostage. What's going on here? Oh, jeez. He's right there. Ooh, a honey badger. Shield guy. Oh no. Alright. Cool. Got a backpack. Completed something. That wasn't the one I was trying to complete. Surely. Oh. Right. That was the one I was trying to complete last time. So, awesome. Okay, one activity there, one activity there. Southwest is way down here, right? Yeah. All right, so we just got to do a couple minor activities, complete these projects, get a bunch of XP. All right, one in Federal Triangle, one in Southwest. Should we? It's the only activity in the neighborhood. All right, fine. We'll do the stupid supply drop. I can't stand these. I'm definitely switching back to my turret, though. That 50-second cooldown is just brutal. Too brutal for me. I've got to be really careful with the supply drop activity, though. It's so easy to get overrun. Not to mention this is out in the middle of everywhere. So random mobs can stumble on us and everything. These activities are very dangerous. The supply drop ones. I've been killed so many times doing supply drops. I just want to switch my skills. Buttons. There we go. Because this is what I'm used to. All right, come get some, I guess. Let's try not to die. All right, the stuff behind me I've got to keep an eye on. It's definitely coming for me. There we go. There they are. Hello. Hello there. So the enemies are trying to open the crates. I don't really care if they do or not. I just want completion of the activity, and I want to not die. Okay, got everybody. As I try to open these, more waves will spawn, I'm pretty sure. Ooh, a magnum. Yeah, there we go. This next wave. Alright, we got this under control. Thankfully, our turret and our drone are helping us out. There's another MG5. Crappy knee pads, because everybody needs crappy knee pads. And there are only three crates, so this and then clearing these mobs out should be the end. Oh no, I got credit for... All right. Even before the enemies died. Awesome. Get him, get him. All right. Nailed it. So that's that project done. That's two projects I could turn in. And now I need one more activity in Southwest. Way the hell down here. Technically, I could just take this control point. I think that's what I'm going to do. Because it's not a very difficult control point to take. And I probably say that about almost every one of them. But you have no idea how many times I've done these control points. It is not a small number. All right. Yep. Welcome to Castle, where everything got destroyed by chemical weapon rockets. Nobody likes that. Actually, I should check the chests over here just while I'm... While I'm in the neighborhood, let's see if there's some good loot for me. What is the snitch down here? Looks like it. It's the snitch. What's up? Snitch bounty. Good luck. All right, we don't actually need the bounty, so I'm going to abort it. It's fine. What I do want are the chests down here. Now, once you reach max level, that snitch guy will reveal the location of the arms dealer, and she'll sell you some cool stuff occasionally. Oh, very nice. Another Fenris chest. But there's also a little area down here with secret side mission to pick up and all. I was here last time, so it's not a huge deal, but there's just a chest here and there that's worth grabbing, so... All right, we're done in here, though. Yeah, we'll go. So this is one of the assault rifles I call Slappy because of the noise it makes when you fire it. We don't need those. Not a bad gun. Whoa. Custom skin for the MK16. Check that out. Fancy. All right, mods in every slot, too. Excellent. Let's see. What else we got? Nothing good. Should we upgrade to this? And we'll hang on to it for now. Oh, awesome. Okay. Purple knee pads. Look at those things. Sexy. Three stats. Purple makes a big difference. Purple's a big jump over blue and especially over green. It's a major, major improvement. All right, let's take our slappy gun and we'll take this control point. I'm not going to switch back to Seeker Mines. It's fine. Oop, got a grenade heavy. Doesn't that sound like a slappy noise? It's kind of funny. Uh-oh. No, no, that's bad. I knew he was going to do that. I was busy reloading and he's like, ha-ha, I've got a grenade for you. I'm fine, though. I'm fine. Oh, what? A shield mod. Wow. Game, don't be so generous. So generous. All right. Let's get our NPCs on the way here. Who else you got? Get him, drone. Drone's doing work. I'm gonna climb up here and assault from right here. Who else you got? Who else you got? Oh, it's a flag in the way. Can't see. Boom. All right. Get him. Yeah. All right. Is that it? Nope. One more. Come on. Come on out. You can do it. Drone again. There we go. All right, got project done, and I'm only halfway done with the control point. So we'll see once we turn in these projects. We might be level 12. Very good chance we might be level 12. All right, there they are. Not much of a threat, but keep in mind this is story mode and I have played this game quite a bit, so I'm only making it look easy. That was a bad inflection. I'm only making it look easy. Uh-oh, medic. Elite medic. Wait, and a red bar medic? Can't put up with that. That's unacceptable. I have no idea what just electrocuted me at all. None at all. That was awesome. Apparently I touched an outlet or something. Wild. All right. There we go. Sliver of life. All right, we're out of here. Okay, a bunch of chests in this control point, or at least a few. Definitely don't need an M44 carbine. That's not my kind of gun. Bolt action, sniper rifle, that does not agree with me. All right, some more materials, get our loot, and we'll go turn in our projects and probably do Jefferson Plot. You see that? Hell yeah. Game just got a lot easier. Okay. getting lucky today so far. Get my reload speed on there. It's 4.7 second reload time. Oh, God. All right. No, I don't need Overlord gloves. And I definitely don't need this shield mod. Get out of here. Get out of here. All right. So there's a bunch of random crap near this control point. Maybe I should go pick up some of it. There's like an echo here and some other shit. I'd have to like run out and go the long way around. Ah, to hell with it. Let's just go. All right, let's go turn in our projects. Sorry about that. I'm back. That was weird. I was like, what did I click? I unhid the Switch source, which covered the PS5 source. Sorry. I know what I'm doing. I promise. I'm good at this stuff. Okay. But we're back. Turn this stuff in. We got, what, 3 projects? Blam, blam, blam. That's 18,000 XP I just got. Couple other projects. And... oh, that didn't quite get us there. Okay, cool. Cool, that's fine. We can make up the difference. I don't think we need to do a whole side mission. What we can do... actually, let's do this side mission. Let's unlock the 4th control point for this neighborhood. It doesn't take very long. I remember the first time I did it took a long time because I had no idea what the hell I was doing. But you basically just have to go into this underground parking garage, save a dude's life, and then pseudo take over a control point. But it doesn't actually give you the control point. It's just like MLK library. You do the side mission, and all that does is make the control point available to take. So you essentially have to take the control point twice, which is fine. You know, it's no big deal. I'm not complaining. It's interesting the way they did the control points, because I know I said it before, but that's a feature that was not in the first Division game. And it gives the map much more of a living, breathing appearance when you have control points. Whereas with the first game, the map was very static. So really all there was to do was missions. All right, I got my M60. We're about to wipe the floor with a whole bunch of enemies. Because this gun is a laser beam. We gotta protect this guy. Now I know I talked a lot of shit when I got that Stoner Lamdry. It is a great gun, but for early game, the M60 is probably the best gun you can find. 100 round magazine, steady as hell. Big bullet damage. The only downside, as with most LMGs, is the enormously long reload time. You know, it's like when I was playing Peach Beach Splash the other week, getting the Gatling gun, and it's like I said, you have to make an appointment to reload that thing. So the cache was empty. And now I have to go do a bunch of stuff. Climb my way out of this parking garage. A lot of enemies here, by the way. I mean, a lot by story mode standards. oh, that must have been what electrocuted me before. There was probably a circuit panel behind me that I wasn't aware of, and someone shot it, and it exploded. And that over there looks like a really good spot for my turret. And it's a little confusing, all the red marks on the map, just because there's multiple verticalities. You know, it's a parking garage, right? So the little ramps spiraling down means there's multiple levels of verticality. Whoa. This Rocket Man over there. Very dangerous. Awesome. All right. We're in a good spot now. There's the Rocketeer. Rocketeer. Dead now. All right. Check out those mad skills. It's the gun. It's not me. Okay. Gonna have to scan these, and then I'm gonna have to do a defend wave, just like a control point. Gunner. Get him. I'm compulsively reloading, although I shouldn't. I'm too used to doing it with the assault rifle, but with the LMGs, you really just need to not do that. Unless it's a RPK, I guess you can get away with it, or L86, you can get away with it. But these ones that have a 4.5 second to 5 second reload time, can't be reloading after every kill. It's not good. It is, in fact, bad. All right. A couple enemies left, and we'll be done. And we'll be level 12, and we can go check vendors again. And then we'll do Jefferson Plaza. Cool, cool, cool. Doing great. All right, we're out of here. Ooh, a pistol magazine blueprint. Rifle. I want a rifle. Okay. Level 12. Hey, that didn't give us a project, did it? No. Okay. Okay, we did complete an activity in East Mall, though, so that's good news. Good coffee. Feeling awake. Okay. See what our cash gives us. Hopefully something good. M249 Bravo is not bad. M60 is, yeah, we'll just upgrade. It's fine. And a rifle that I don't want. I mean, it looks the same as the MK16 and MK17 look the same, but one is semi-auto, and that's the one I don't like. Ooh, a Wyvern backpack. I'll absolutely take that. Get out of here. Meh. And we'll stick with the skill tier chest piece for now. Wait, was that an actual upgrade? No. No, it was not. Alright. M249 Bravo is very similar to the M60, slightly higher RPM. Not as much of a laser beam, but it gets a cool skin. So there's that. Ammunition. There we go. 4.6 second reload time. So it's 0.1 seconds faster. Awesome. All right. What does Vendor Dude have for me? Same stuff. Similar stuff. Doesn't always drastically change level by level, but it does. It does change. Like I said, it can change anyway. Especially Clan Vendor can change. It's unfortunate that the high-end item is the Emeline's Guard, but I think that will change as I continue to level. Yeah, shit. All right. Well, let's do the mission. Let's go do it. We've done this one a few times. It's, I don't want to say it's dangerous. It's not super easy, but on hardcore, it's not going to be that bad anyway. It's story mode. It's fine. Now, on the way, there are some SHD caches I can grab. There's also loot and crap in this neighborhood, too. You know, sometimes it's worth exploring. I'm not going to do much exploring today because I don't need to. However, if you feel interested in the Division 2 lore and what the hell's going on in the story, definitely explore. Pick up cell phones, pick up echoes, etc. Worth your while. Okay. Oh, that's right. Step in the train cars. I'm not going to worry about that right now. The Jefferson Plaza is just over here. There is a chest. A couple chests in this vicinity, obviously. Worth grabbing stuff just to have it, I guess. I do need to make my way over this way. There are chests and different things in the train cars that are down below me right now, but I don't really want to get involved in that. I want to get to the mission. But if there are chests, I'm cool with grabbing chests. Another MG5. All right, we're also right by Dark Zone South, and there just happen to be a couple of places where world bosses can spawn and where there are chests down here. So we might end up grabbing those as we see them. All right, my buddies have control of this area where there are components. It might be worth grabbing some components here for the sake of restocking control points if and when we need to do that for additional projects. Another green MG5. Well, happy birthday to me. All right. Any other... more train car crap. So over here is the wall for DZ South. Now, I said I wasn't going to be going in the Dark Zone, and I don't plan to, but it does exist. You have to actually unlock it, do the... to talk to the Dark Zone officer in the White House and actually unlock it, but I'm not going to worry about that. All it really does for me is provide some fast travel location, fast travel points. So, whoopty shit. I'm not going in the Dark Zone. I don't even go in the Dark Zone when it's not hardcore mode. All right. Jefferson Plaza coming up. Jefferson Plaza is a story mission against the True Sons. A lot of corridors, a lot of inside rooms. We're going to be down in a basement for a while near some DC-62 poison zones. And the end, the boss fight is against a big somebody with a mortar that can get a little dicey. I kind of want to matchmake just in case anybody else is playing today. What the hell? I don't think we'll actually find anybody. So. Apparently it's not going to let me. That's interesting. Maybe I can do this on the map. Something went wrong. Oh, it doesn't want me to matchmake. All right. They recently did an update to the game, and I think they broke some shit. Some aspects of matchmaking are better. Obviously, this aspect in this particular case is not better. So, woo. All right. First room, best spot right here against these bags. There's going to be enemies spawning from the far side. I'm going to throw my turret way over there so it's not in my way. And let's kick some ass. I see you, sniper. Lulling you into a false sense of security. So the M249 Bravo is slightly less steady than the M60. Just the handling on it is a little bit different. It's not a bad gun. Higher RPM slightly, but the steadiness just isn't the same. So that's why I was super happy when I got the M60, not as happy when I got the M249. It is a all-around mediocre gun. And that's the stage where we are with the loot pool. We're getting a lot of mediocre guns, and that's going to continue to happen until we're mid-20s, then we're going to get a lot of good guns. Once we get to 30 and then 40, we'll get all the best guns. We won't even see an exotic for quite some time, so. All right. More enemies. That was a lucky headshot. There's something here I need to blow up. Where is it? There it is. Just shooting it now to get it out of the way. Like a train car full of explosives or something. I can't even. I'm too far away. Just messing around. There we go. Alright. Destroyed the thing I was supposed to destroy. Just have to fight all these dudes off. Get to the next room. Doesn't look suppressed to me. They don't look very suppressed when they start running. That's a different thing. Left some steel on the ground. I'm gonna go pick that up. Drone finished it off for me. Thanks, drone. All right. Got to go through some utility corridors. I thought there was more enemies in here, but there's only two. Bless you, story mode. All right, let's grab bullets. Not med kits, bullets. Thank you. There we go. All right. Climb up here. So fun fact, you could either climb up the ladder or you can hop up this way. Both are acceptable. And in this particular area, the spa, this has the potential to be really annoying. Hey, this is a classic M60. I'd have cared way more about classic M60 if I was like level 5. So. Not a big deal. All right, I'm going to put my turret in a creative position. And kick some ass. They got a turret. That's not good. There we go. Okay. A lot of enemies in this room. Okay. So the annoying thing that can happen is enemies will spawn up there, and you can't physically get to them. So they can sit up there and just camp and shoot at you. And if you get a medic up there, or if you're doing the invaded version of this mission and you get a lunchbox guy up there, oh my god, this takes so long. This room just takes so long in those cases, so it can get really annoying. Otherwise, it's not a bad mission. This mission's okay. This next room is probably my least favorite, though. This room can be really, really overwhelming, so... Not necessarily on story mode, but we, you know, we'll be okay. We're always okay. We got this under control. We're good at this. All right. So the True Sons have the Riot Foam Rushers, which will crowd control you. In Soviet Russia, game crowd controls you. Right. Oop. Usually there's an enemy that usually the engineers will spawn down there, but didn't get one this time, so I just wasted a grenade. That's okay. It's always weird, you know, playing story mode versus the levels of difficulty that, you know, you play at endgame in this game. Going back to story mode is just jarring because it's like, that was it. They just fell over. But yes, they do just fall over, but they also do shoot back. And when you get 5 or 6 of them shooting at you at once, especially veterans and elites, or if there are named enemies, or if you get the heavies... They shoot really, really hard. All right. So I'm in the poison area. I've got to watch out not to stand in the poison clouds. Because that will just sap your HP. Not even your armor. It'll just straight sap your HP and kill you really fast. Nope, that was the wrong button. I'm good. I'm fine. I know what I'm doing. I promise. There we go. This room is so festive. Oh, we got... Oh, he can't hit me because his grenades hit the ceiling. Oh, man. Oh, he didn't drop anything. He needs to drop stuff, but that's only the overworld versions of them. They're not guaranteed to drop stuff. It's just the overworld versions of them usually do. But the way it works is the more difficult the enemy in this game, the more likely they are to drop something. So you're way more likely to get loot drops from elites, and you're usually guaranteed to get loot drops from named enemies, bosses and such. two heavy gunners, two red bar heavy gunners. Crazy. Shoot the three tanks in this room. Okay. Now, fun fact, you can enter the next room either from this side or from the left side. This side, you get a little restock. Gonna wait for my turret cooldown to come back up briefly. Okay. Let's hit it. Now, two best spots are either right here or up here. But there are a lot of ways to do this particular room. Who else you got? Come on. There you are. Cool. All right, there is a True Sons key box in this elevator shaft, but I'm not going to grab it. My policy is I do not grab key boxes if I am alone. Then it's a waste of a key. All right, all we got left is the boss room. Which, the biggest trouble is the mortar. Because mortars hurt and they make you bleed. And if you get hit by one of them, it might mess you up real bad. So, gonna try and avoid that as much as possible. I broke down my drone, so I'm just taking a second, letting my cooldown come back up. I have time, so we'll hang on to that. We don't need that. All right. Now, there is an orange box here. It is right there. So I'm going to shoot that just to get it spawned, and let's go kill some stuff. Now, typically, I would post up right about there or there and just kind of chill in cover. This time, I'm going to chill over here, which is also a good spot. Because all the enemies are going to be spawning out of that door, or they're going to be spawning up here, or they're going to be spawning up there. There's the mortar guy. He's dead. There will be more of them, so I've got to keep an eye out. Next mortar guy. Okay. Here comes the boss. All That was it. That was it. Got another skill unlock. Ooh, an Iraldi piece. Not that it helps me, but it's cool to see the loot pool opening up a little more. Seeing a lot of colors. All right. Oh boy. All right, and we hit level 13. Damn, that was productive. That was very productive. We'll hop back to the base. Honestly, I'm tempted to just move, just push forward and do Space Administration Headquarters, which is the next mission. I do like that mission, except the part where you gotta move the satellite dishes, especially by myself. That's gonna be interesting. You know, then again, maybe I should get to level 14 just in case. We'll have to see what our projects are, what condition they're in. All right. Check our weaponry. We don't need an M700, although that is a pretty decent sniper rifle if you like those. Definitely don't need a level 12 RPK. Let's see. Nope. Game's not giving me any good masks. Yeah, what the hell? We'll keep it going. Okay. I'm at 34 of 90, and I don't have any inventory management problems anymore. I need two activities in East Mall, which could just be control points. Uh-oh. What happened here? I didn't get the other control point. That's weird. All right, well, we'll just take some control points. What the hell? I'm sure the game will figure itself out eventually. I am not hugely troubled by it. All right, so this Metro Ruins control point is underground. It is a very interesting control point because of that reason. To get there, there's a little rope. I mean, there's a couple of different ways to get there, obviously, but I'm gonna go a little rope here. Oh, dodge some enemies. Look at that. Look how much of a ninja I am. All right, so we're just gonna roll in. Now, the tough thing is because it's underground and you need to shoot a flare to get your NPC buddies to come help you, you actually have to go, either you can clear the control point halfway and then shoot your flare, or you can walk up here, try not to be seen. There we go. All right. And I'm just thinking about turret placement. Let's see if we can reach over there. We can. Excellent. Excellent. All right. Let's do this. Hanging back because the enemies spawn from this central area, you can see them running out. If I try to play aggressively, I will get enemies spawning everywhere around me, and that's really, really bad. On the other hand, looks like some dudes coming from behind me anyway, so no problem. Heal dealt with, and we got boss wave. He's just an elite rifleman. We can deal with that. I was a little concerned he would be a rocket man. Nobody wants rocket man. Oh, hello. Okay. So I've disabled the turret by shooting its ammo belt. You don't have to destroy a turret if you disable it. Alright. Nope. This one. Thank you. Okay. Turret. Oh, cool. They're still coming from the same direction. Sometimes they can spawn from behind you. Again, they spawn randomly, which is good. It keeps these control points interesting. Oh, no, you don't. Oh, no, you don't. Ha, 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 ha. Take that. That's it. Completed a project. Got some crappy loot. Getting some trinkets. Oh, tiny amount of food. And polycarbonate. All right. So what did I... All right. Cash is in Southwest. Activities in Southwest. Restock a control point. Restock a control point in East Mall. All right. So this will be, I think it's the bounty project. So restock this and then go kill a bounty, and then I can turn in the project. As long as our supplies are going to last. Ooh. Okay. And that should give me X-ray vision as well. All right, there's our bounty. It's a really strange place for it to be. We'll head there from the safe house. I'm a little concerned that I did the side mission and did not get the control point. It's very strange. It's not out of character for this game, of course. I feel like I've made that complaint before. Some things just go wrong. But it's weird every time. What? Who is this? What are these guys doing? Is it a world boss? Usually if you see purples in the overworld, typically it's a world boss. They could be part of the bounty, but most of the time... Oh, hello. He was just laying on the ground hiding. Mr. Camouflage over here. Oh, there's some mob. Oh, nope. Get him. Okay, they were part of the bounty. No big deal. Oh, I got some NPCs helping me out. Awesome. Get him, guys. There's the bounty. He's taking a med kit. Oh, no. Oh, no. All that effort. All right, it's fine. Killed my drone. You son of a bitch. Blind fire, and you're dead. Okay. I was really lazy, but... it's fine. I got an assault rifle. What did I get? What a wonderful goddamn day to be alive. AKM. Ooh. That's acceptable. All right, these NPCs are around me, so I'm semi-safe to switch out. AKM. I don't have a 7.62 meg. That's fine. Okay. Don't need the slappy gun anymore. So that's good news. Did we get a better mask? No, we still have not gotten a better mask. Oh, it did. Okay, so now I do officially have the control point. That's really weird that it wasn't showing up, and I also shouldn't have it. It's really strange. So they changed how that works for probably no reason at all, which is fine, whatever. All right, should we do the Southwest stuff too? I guess we should. Let's go pick up caches and restock this control point. And then we'll have another bounty to do. And then when we turn in these projects, or turn in this one other project, it should conceivably get us to level 14. That's the goal. And if it doesn't, well, there's always side project, or there's always side missions, as well as other stuff. Okay. Yeah, there's also multiple echoes in this neighborhood. Here's one. Just grabbing it for the XP. I don't really need to watch it. There's our cache. Could be a chest in here too somewhere, maybe? No. Rather unfortunate. All right, next one is in that. Where is that? Oh, I know where that is. Let's see. I think it'd be faster to go from here because the ins and outs of the buildings in between here and where the other cache is may look cool, but it just takes longer, and I don't have the patience for that right now. Okay. Downstairs. That's right. Uh-oh. Ouch. That was both lucky and unlucky. I didn't really want to run into that dude, but Hey, dropped a holster. And it's purple. And it's skill tier. Which means I can just put on a different mask. That'll work. Alright. Always, if you can and you have time, if you run into a heavy in the overworld, definitely kill it. Definitely. High percentage chance for them to drop something useful. Because they are so dangerous. All right, yeah, this here, and we can do that activity when we go there too. Yeah, we're an hour and a half in, doing great. So, looks like I'm gonna run out of LMG ammo eventually. I'm a little liberal with my application of bullets. Is this? That's what I thought. Propaganda broadcast. System. Where's the speaker? Oh, it's way over there. What? That was confusing. Alright, where are they coming from? That way. Steel on the ground, might as well pick it up. Everybody loves steel.
You think God'll save you?
Alright. Next wave. Who else you got? I'm from there again. Some bullshit knee pads. Awesome. Everybody loves knee pads. This little playground over here, that's where the cache is. Kind of cute. Also loot. If that's what you want to call it. All right, there's our cache. Hey, Lacey. What's up? Happy American Thanksgiving. That's not worth putting on. And we don't need that. All right. Where are we at? We are almost to level 14. What's up? Let's do this other control point. And that should kick us up to level, I think. And then we can do the next mission. We are cruising right along here. Nice. She's pretty tough. I like when I make hardcore characters, I don't change their outfits. So they get kind of defaulted into a tiny amount of cosmetics that you get at the very beginning of the game. But yeah, she looks pretty badass. She is pretty badass. She's making her way in this horrible world and doing just fine. I saw you were playing your dragon consuming game earlier. How'd that go? Did you eat more dragons? It's a helicopter. It's the rear of the control point. We don't have to worry about that. This control point. Oh, cool. Do you feel like you've fully relearned the game again? You said you haven't played since like September, right? Okay, that was nothing. Oh, man. All right, here we go. Yeah, sometimes I find that, and it's usually because I started a new save because I forgot how to play the game. So I'm like, please tutorialize me over again. Or, you know, you never know. Maybe you were showing someone the game and were like, and they wanted to start over. Who knows? All kinds of possibilities. Oh, got that medic. Love it. All these headshots. I'm on fire today. Getting headshots with an LMG is no small thing. That's cool. JRPGs give you a lot of opportunity to bum around. For some games, that's more fun than doing the story. Nope. No sweat at all, but it's only like 65 here today. I mean, 65F. So it's nice and cool. All right. Defend wave. Let's do this. And the AK crits for a hell of a lot of HP. Where are you at? Come on. Come out so I can shoot at you. There we go. They'll get here eventually. Oh, he's an engineer. No. No turrets, please. I'm the only one allowed to put turrets down. Really? Okay. This control point's done. That's all the control points in the neighborhood, and I still didn't get to level 14, but that's okay. We're almost there. You keep triggering my disallowed phrases. I don't even know what could have triggered it there. Try hard? Try hard is apparently a slur. I have no idea. Okay. That's funny. Yeah, I saw you were playing Ghost way early this morning, but I was not awake enough to hang out. I got up like 4 hours ago. That's cool, though. I mean, have you just been doing more healing and stuff? Or have you switched to something else? One more cash and restock this dude, and then we'll be able to do the bounty, and that should kick us over to 14. It's right next to a loot drop. What's up, CPO? What do you need? Damn, you need everything. You can have all my supplies. There you go. Oh, nice. I mean, not nice that you'll be getting steamrolled, but I noticed you've been working on unlocking those legendaries. I have not gotten there in Ghost. I need to play a whole bunch more of the multiplayer. I think I got into like rank, I want to say like 11 or 12 on my new assassin on my new save. But I have not devoted a ton of time to it. I've been trying to get my friend who used to play it with me. I've been trying to get him to play it again, but he'd rather play this, funnily enough. He loves this game. He loves this game as much as I do, I guess. Maybe more than I do. All right. That's right. We got to go around to the other side of the train. Yeah, that's true. It's a great game, though, but yeah, it's kind of an undertaking. Especially the multiplayer, you die so fast and you can look like such a dipshit if you just join multiplayer and scrub it up. All right, come on, train cars. What the hell? I guess I gotta go the other way around. That's fine. I got all day. I got all the time in the war. Oh, who's this? Oh, it's True Sons fighting some hyenas. They're doing here. Aside from annoying me. Alright, I need that, but obviously I can't open the chest through the wall. Some chests you can open through the wall, but not the SHD caches. Thought that said gardening for a second. Yeah, it is a long time. Ah, you can't shoot me through the leaves. Take that. Oh, shit. Are you kidding? All right. This is getting ridiculous. I need to go south. But I cannot get through here. You know what? Fuck that cash. I'm just gonna go do the other one. Ain't nobody got time for this shit. Fuck that train. Ridiculous. Oh, this is the one where it spawns you in the closet. You gotta run out of like three rooms. There we go. I'm fine. I'll be fine. Everything's fine. So close to level 14. are some spooky bits in this game for sure. And later on, when you do the Coney Island missions, you actually have to go through like the haunted house or kind of a haunted house section on Coney Island. It's cool. I'm gonna do this territory control because it's here. That'll get me some XP. And it's only one wave after these guys, so it's no big deal. Next. You gonna... There you are. Welcome to the party. Okay. Sport. Oh, that's another heavy gunner. He's doing what I do. Just post up and hold the trigger down. Fight fire with fire. Here we go. And toast. Grab the key. Let my drone take care of the rest of it, apparently. I wasn't kidding. Drone doing work. Oh, what was that? G36. Ooh. Nope. Do not need an M700. That still didn't get us to level 14. Wow. All right, what's the G36 look like? Green. I don't need a green one. It's not going to be better than the AK. Don't care about those. And I got a mod. Don't really need it. Okay. Carry on. Oh, that was my dog. Break down the drone. There's a bunch of enemies over there. Oh. I'm frozen. There we go. Oh my. Okay. That is the worst thing that can happen during hardcore mode. I'm super scared now. I don't want to die to a screen freeze. Holy shit. Oh, there it goes again. Oh no. I really should just grab this cash and get the hell out of here. At least there are some friendly NPCs nearby to cover me. No, don't shoot at me. Leave me alone. Awesome. Okay, got the bounty. It's over there. I'm gonna take a second in the safe house just to give the game a chance to calm down, because I do not want to have it continue to freeze on me. And besides, I got my level 14. All right. Terrible gun. No, thank you. Let's see. It seems to be okay. I'm not seeing more issues. I think I'm going to risk it. I think I'm going to risk it. Let's do the bounty. If we die, we die. I don't want to start all the way over from level 14, but you know what? That's what gambling is, man. You gamble. You take risks. And if you don't, what kind of life is that? It's not very hardcore, if you ask me. Oh shit, there's tons of enemies around. This is risky. I've embedded my turret in the cover. Awesome. Surely it'll be useful there. Getting flanked. Ooh. Crash ninjas. Unacceptable. All right. Awesome. I didn't want it in there anyway. Who you got? Oh, there's the boss. Wow. The drone fucked him up. No. No. There we go. Okay. And she tried a med kit twice. Wow. The drone was not having any of that. Damn. All right. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. So we got level 14. We got a double barrel sawed off for no reason. We get to turn in that last project and next days pass. Yes. I try to keep it entertaining around here. That's it for my coffee. I'm gonna switch to water now. All right. Another blueprint. Don't care about. Let's check the vendor. What do you got? Whoa. That was a bad selection. Wow. Okay. That is all of our projects so far. Yeah, We're done on projects until we discover a new neighborhood. All that's left is this mission, and then we're going to be heading over into here, and we're going to start on the west side of the map. So, yeah, let's hit Space Administration and keep our fingers and toes crossed that the game doesn't freeze up like it was doing a little bit ago. That's probably the only thing that'll kill me. That and hubris. I think I remember every time I've died in hardcore mode in this game. Because everywhere I've died, I'm automatically doubly cautious. But like when I get to the outcast missions, I'm going to be so careful because one of the last times I died was at like level 17 doing one of the outcast missions. Because they have suicide bombers and they hurt. So another double barrel. Well, now it's a double barrel shotgun, not a double barrel sawed off. So never mind. Two of the worst guns in this game. A lot of random enemies. All right, we're fine now. True Sons v. Trash Ninjas v. Division Agent. Guess who's going to win? The one with the giant machine gun. So I'm going to guess matchmaking is still broken, so I'm just going to do this myself. Let's hit it. A couple of interesting things about this mission. A lot of, like, atrium-style rooms, so you can essentially get attacked or attack from varying verticalities, different, you know, different floors. Once we get inside the building, it's pretty entertaining. But this is some sort of, what is it? NOAA? The National Oceanic something, maybe? I don't know what it is. I don't know stuff. Heavy gunners are running away from my drone. Get him. Oof. Getting shot. They shoot back. Water. There we go. I didn't leave anything on the ground, did I? Nope. You would do fine. You're fine. I think, you know, if you've never tried this game, it's really not so bad. But again, this is just story mode, so the goal is to master the basics, and then you do the higher difficulties once you get to endgame and stuff, and there's way more difficult stuff in endgame. But there's also more guns, better skills, different skill variants, all kinds of advantages you can get over these enemies, so. I don't know. This game's got a really good mix of stuff. I like it a lot. It's not perfect, but I like it a lot, and there's, you know, hundreds of hours of fun in this game. But I'm playing super cautiously, too. When I play regularly, I'm super aggressive because, you know, this is permadeath and I don't want to have to start over again. But when I actually am allowed to die and not fully reset all of my progress on my character, I do play super aggressively. And this game is hella fun for that. With, like, shields and shotguns and different sorts of setups. Got another wave. I thought that was the room, but I got another wave. Something that also changes the game, too, is the multiplayer aspect. If you can get four people together, the game scales up the difficulty. It'll increase the number of enemies and increase their strength. And it's just so much more fun when the enemies have something to shoot at other than you. And you can, you know, flank them and do, you know, different stuff. I do some of that just because I have a turret and a drone. I'm able to move around a little and have some freedom, but it's so much better when you have humans. A lot of the time, the enemies are also massive cowards, and they will just hide from you. So, there's that. I was saying before you joined, there's one of the rooms, it's actually right before the, I think it's third to the last room, where you've got to rotate the satellite dishes once I get all the way to the rooftop. That's definitely the toughest room in this mission, and there's high potential for me to die there, so I have to be very careful doing that room. This mission, even though it's story mode, some of these missions do have some difficult parts. But I wouldn't say it's super sweaty. It's just, it varies, you know, it varies. More headshots. Yeah, what you get? I guess I can play a little more aggressively. Playing aggressively, I think, is what makes this game more entertaining to play and to watch. But it'll also get you killed, so there's that. Need ammo. Okay. See what I was saying earlier? There's a lot of like atrium style portions to this mission. Oh, really? Oh. He caught on to my plan. okay. Yeah, I don't think we can shoot each other through that glass, so you're welcome to try. There we go. All right. Jumped off even though he was on fire. That is one brave shotgunner. Oh, dude killed my drone. Okay, I'll have to put up with that. That's the wrong cover. There we go. It's like I was playing Outriders for a second. One of my issues with Outriders is taking cover is kind of the same way as it is in this game, but you will randomly take cover on walls and stuff that you're like not aiming at, and it will really mess you up. It happens to me all the time in that game when I used to play it. One of the many things that's frustrating about Outriders. All right, we got police M4. Yeah. It's not really better, but it's more fun to shoot. So I'm going to switch. Because I've had this AK for a while. Cool. All right. And because it's green, I don't get a skin, which is fine. I'm mostly going to be relying on this thing anyway. The large... magazine LMGs are just the workhorses of this, of the early parts of this game. But I'm just a much bigger fan of assault rifles, so. Hit the computer. All right. So this is the satellite dish part. I'm going to have to go through this pretty slowly. Being alone... for this part is awful. There's so much territory to cover. There's so many enemies that spawn here. And more enemies will spawn while I'm rotating the satellite dishes. So it's just super dangerous. You're very, very exposed while you're hitting the button. Because you essentially have to go hold down a button for 8 or 10 seconds. Alright. As soon as I start doing this, it's going to trigger the next wave. So I've got to keep... got to keep an eye out. Because they'll be coming from right over there. There they are. What's up, guys? Bam, 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 bam. Only lost 3 bricks of armor while I was animation locked. Oh, shotgunner. Oh, no. Just a grenader. I'm gonna get you. That was super lazy, but I wanted to do it anyway. And they're everywhere. All right, I'm gonna head toward B. My drone's about to die. What? That's unexpected. I heard him. There he was. Okay. Gotta be overly cautious. Okay. Just gonna let my armor come back before I hit that next button. Grab my loot, which is just a drone mod. Woo. All right, let's put our turret here. We'll hit the B button. This is like I was saying, this room takes ages when you're by yourself. It's just, it takes so damn long. Let's see if we can get the button. No, we cannot. Okay. Be able to get the button, and we'll still get another wave, I think. At least one more, probably. Or maybe it's, nope, there we go. Got the buttons. Now we just gotta kill everything. And we have one large room with a bunch of waves, and then we got the boss room, which is also a large room with a bunch of waves. Oh god. Oh shit. Okay. I'm lucky that was just a red bar rifleman, because he snuck up right behind me. Okay, who's next? Grenade this. Uh-oh. Okay. Ooh. Woo! Getting a little hairy here. All right. Just kidding. That wasn't so bad. All right. Grab our loot, move on. That wasn't loot, it was just steel. What's wrong with steel? And let's get ammo just so we don't have to worry about it. Okay, next room is huge. I have to hit a couple of buttons again because I'm by myself. Usually when I play this mission with other people, I make them hit the buttons so that I can focus on killing stuff. But that's okay. I don't mind hitting buttons. First button right here. Whenever you feel like it, game. There we go. I don't know what's going on, but it's fine. Next button's over here, so I'm just gonna cruise over here and shoot everything from here. Too far away because his gun's very unsteady. They were poking their head out though. What you get? Second button. Gotta kill everything now. I'm gonna get one more wave. Wow, that was a long headshot. That was pretty lucky. Who else you got? Come and get some. I'm giving away bullets. Free bullets. Liking my HP level here. Oh god. That is a rocket. I don't want to die to that. Those things hit so hard. Okay. Just the rocket person left. Rocket man. You are gonna die alone. There we go. Okay, we're out of here. Get some special ammo for the LMG. And go fight a boss room. Which actually, this boss fight's pretty cool. Once you clear the room out, the boss makes a rather impressive entrance. Okay. Just gonna take a second, let my drone cooldown come back up. Do this. Rockets to the moon. Hide and be suppressed. I'm gonna throw grenades at you until you die. That's the way this works. really watch out for the rockets, though. Yeah, there you are. Hiding a little too well, and the gun's just not steady enough. Okay. Yeah, good luck with that. All right. After this rocket person goes down. All right, boss fight time. So I mentioned the boss makes a cool entrance. He's going to be coming from up there. Right between those two fixtures above the Noah banner. That's where the boss is going to appear. Whoa. Just mop up the ads and we're out of here. Keep an eye out for rockets, as always. You're so far away. Okay. That was a lucky headshot. This guy's the last one. Unfortunately, I have to run all the way back over here and hit a button. There we go. See? I didn't want to have to run all the way over there. The drone killed the dude with its dying breath. That's awesome. Oh, and thank you. Yep. My luck held through. Yeah, honestly, this room is less difficult than the damn satellite dishes. Lasted about not even half as long as that room. Alright, we made it. And we made it to level 15. Awesome. Alright. Man, we're halfway to level 30. There's a bunch of stuff that happens at level 30. So it's pretty awesome to be halfway there. Yeah, we don't care about that. Okay. Back to the base. And then we're going to run over to the campus. Whereupon we will get new projects. We're going to unlock a handful of new missions. There's more safe houses to grab. Oh yeah, bank mission is next. I love bank mission. Definitely want to do bank mission. It's probably a level 16 mission, but I may end up just doing it. All right, base of operations upgraded. Let's see if he's got anything new. Oh, he's got an MK16. I don't really need that, but it's cool that he has it. We're going to hang on to our stuff just in case we got to donate to projects. Let's see what we get out of our cash. Excellent. Excellent. Love this gun. So glad every time I get one of them. It's usually one of the first high-end assault rifles that the game gives me playing hardcore mode, and it's just, it's a big mistake every time. It just turns game into easy mode because this gun is so stable. Love the G36 in this game. I don't know why it keeps giving me mods, but one of the most annoying things about the early levels in this game is the stat boosts are so ridiculously low. Like 1.5% of some stat is a joke. It's a joke. But once you get to max level, that's like a 10% bonus when it's full. So it's just the scaling is set way too low for low level. But it opens up. It opens up eventually. All right, I guess let's unlock Pulse. We will do Jammer Pulse because I love Jammer Pulse. Don't need it. And let's unlock. Put that. We'll unlock the Blinder Firefly, which is fun. And how about, do we have perks? Yeah, might as well. We got a lot of SHD tech, so might as well use it. Got a lot of tech because I haven't been unlocking perks. I got like the perks I care about and then forgot that perks existed. Oh yeah, I forgot to give myself the X-ray vision perks. There we go. Now when I restock control points, it actually does something. Give me the rest of the useless weapon mods that I don't need. Material storage. Lots and lots of perks. All right. Don't really care about the shooting range guy. I'm assuming we still cannot. Yeah, we still can't recalibrate. We need somebody special for that. All right. I don't think we need any weapon mods. Might as well, though, since we're here. All right. Cool. All right, so we're heading to the campus. And I could run there from here, but I'm lazy, so I'm going to run there from here. I don't like having a slow walk half the distance to get out of the White House. You know? Skip it. All right. We already got all our loot here at the beginning of the session, so these chests will not have repopulated. Got some hyenas at a propaganda broadcast, and I guess we might as well take them out. And look how steady that is. I mean, seriously. This thing is a laser beam. It's ridiculously steady. Turret got embedded in the terrain and I can't pick it back up. It's okay. I'll survive, I guess. Where are they coming from? Over there. Cool. Key? No key? Where's the key? Ah, another wave. Oh, I got NPCs to help me. Cool. There's the key. Good deal. Hi, Lulu. Hi, Lulu. All right. Fighting on, one day at a time. There are plenty of hidden pleasures on offer. I don't want to run over there. I just got to run back to hit the button anyway. That's why I have guns. All right. That done. I probably should have waited to do that so I would get credit toward the projects I'm about to pick up, but not a big deal. Hi, Lulu. Hi, sweet. How you know? You're so cute. Okay. Let's get to the campus and get our story stuff going, and then we will do bank mission. Maybe. We'll see. It's a heavy. Always kill the heavies in the overworld. Let's get them. Oh, he dropped a mod. That sucks. All right, here's the campus. All right, I'm going to go talk to Henry Hayes, and I might actually let this story stuff cutscene play so that I can let Lulu outside. And actually take a short bathroom break. So let me get the cutscene started. And I'm back. So Lulu went to go lay outside in the sunshine because it's so nice out. So I'm just leaving the door open for a bit, but I will have to get up and shut it in a little bit. All right. So, yeah, bank mission is for level 16. You don't have to be level 16 to do it. So I could just go do it. I do like bank mission a lot, so it's really tempting. I'll think it over. I got some crap to pick up in this particular zone. There's our new projects. One of them anyway. Some side missions and also, of course, another vendor.
Great to see you, Agent.
Selling complete trash.
Your business is-
All right, give me that side mission.
Agent, we-
Site. I don't think there's any side missions that I'm really in need of. Genuinely, the only one I give that much of a shit about is the light extended magazine, and that's the one I got at like level 7 after doing the American History Museum. So that was taken care of half my levels ago. All right. Oh, there's more cell phones. There's always more cell phones. But since they give you a pittance of XP, I grab them. There's no real reason not to grab them. All right. Done everything there is to do here. Let's take a look at what the projects want us to do. Get some donations going. Need to aid hostage rescue, which those aren't easy to find. One of these two might be hostage rescue. So what the hell? Let's go check it out. Let's go do some activities. See if we can get up to level 16, then we'll do bank mission, and then maybe we'll take a lunch break. Because that's still about an hour away. Awesome. Get a little XP bonus for the collectible subset. Everybody likes that. I'm almost halfway to level 16. All right. Let's see what we're working with up here. Public execution is not what I'm looking for. And unfortunately, I triggered it from way the hell far off. So now I gotta run up in here and save their asses. More enemies. I think I gotta go upstairs. Alright, there's a territory control right there. That is not a hostage rescue. The hostage rescue has the icon of the handcuffs on the map. That's the type of activity it is. Why are these hostages running so far away? Guys, I can't protect you if you're way the hell over there. I actually hit two of them with my blindly thrown grenade. Okay. Oh, bless story mode. Not a hostage rescue. Makes me wonder if down here is a hostage rescue. Because I know that's territory control. It's even marked now. So let's go down here. Let's see what's going on over there. Oh, another cell phone out here. Okay. Think. Oh, these are outcasts. Oh, it's just territory control. I don't want to do that. Let's see what that one is. Territory controls are a dime a dozen. Another cell phone. Must be inside the building. Or above me. Or below me. Could be anywhere, really. But I don't care. They're not that important. Excuse me. This gonna be hostage? Please? Please? Nope. Elite territory control. Oh shit. It means I'm gonna be fighting elites. Oh, I got NPCs. Oh, nope. I do not have NPCs here to help me. That is a world boss. Oh, shit. All right, this could get hairy. This could get hairy real fast. Who's behind me? I don't know what the hell that enemy was doing way over there. With a sniper. Okay. I gotta go find that world boss, though. That was a medic. They're gonna be raising people left and right. Hope he didn't despawn. He's still alive. Oh, this is a different world boss. What? This game's really confusing sometimes. Fancy? Also, the dude's name is Fancy? Oh, that is a high end. I bet that's an Emmeline's guard. I would bet 25 cents that's an Emmeline's guard. Oh, these mobs are level 17. They're on the other side of the boundary. All right, whatever. The drone can finish them off. Oh, and I got the key. Ah, Emmeline's guard called it. Universe owes me 25 cents. Get up the stairs, please. Alright. Ugh, 6, 7, 16. No thank you. Another one of my least favorite guns. Okay. Where's the third one? There it is. It's right in front of me. If it was a snake, it would have bit me. So elite activities give you double XP. So they are worth doing, but I hardly ever see them. Let's see what that is. Maybe that'll be the hostage rescue that we're looking for. Excuse me. The problem is the hostage rescue is the rarest of the open world activities. You get territory control and propaganda broadcast all the time. But for whatever reason, it doesn't consistently spawn hostage rescues. It's just a rare activity. I don't make the rules. I also don't particularly enjoy the hostage rescue activity. Not that it's difficult or anything. It's just kind of annoying. Oh, it's another territory control. So the territory controls right next to each other. How fun. You know, maybe it's that you don't get the hostage rescue until you have control points taken over. Maybe I need to secure the neighborhood before I start seeing hostage rescues. You know, got to do the control points. I mean, I don't have to do the control points, but you kind of got to do at least one of them if you want to do the project, because you have to restock a friendly control point in the neighborhood alongside picking up caches and whatever. So, let's take over the World's End, which is not a great control point. It's okay. It's not my favorite. For this particular one, I am attacking from the south. You can also attack from the north if you feel better about that. And I hang out over here. So you have kind of a pretty decent view of the control point where enemies are spawning from and whatever. I'm going to throw my turret down on the truck. And let's get our NPCs on the way. We just definitely have to keep an eye out for anything coming from the west, because we are right next to the border of the next neighborhood, and they will be the mobs from there will be higher level. So we just gotta keep an eye out. It's a little dangerous. It's fine though. We're fine. Everything's fine. It's way too far away. So if you do attack from the north like the NPCs are about to do, there's a little courtyard there. It's not very defensible. So I choose to attack from the south because you have this little elevated area where you can kind of camp out. Awesome. All right. I'm going to move in since we're Just about done with the attack wave. Well, these are outcasts. I thought we were fighting hyenas, but that's fine. Alright, both my drone and my turret are down. That's not ideal. Oh god. That was a suicide bomber, and I am very lucky I did not get hugged to death. Little bit risky. Awesome. All right. Aside from that one brief moment of panic, that went great. Almost ran out of ammo. Like you do. Okay. We are almost to level 16. Should probably... I didn't mean to discover West End. That's funny. You discover West End from being inside the supply room. Awesome. All right. That sounds like there's some shooting going on out there. I don't need to worry about that, though. Let's go take Toxic Alley, which used to be my nickname for Reddit. Gotta love it. Toxic Alley is actually a pretty cool control point. You can attack it from the west or the east. And there are reasons to do either, I guess. I prefer attacking from the east, but it is further away. But on the other hand, we get to shoot this dude, so... hit him with an axe. You see this? This is crazy. I have never seen an NPC go at a heavy with an axe before. That's awesome. That is just straight awesome. All right, what did I get? Knee pads. Bullshit knee pads, but knee pads. Let's see, we're almost to 3 hours here. We're doing great. So the plan is take Toxic Alley. Then we'll do bank mission because we'll be level 16. And then I think I'm going to go have lunch. And that might be all for today. We'll see. I don't think I'll get back on. I think I'll get back on and play something else. But we'll see. Oh, hello. Hello there. Fancy meeting you here. Good. There's another propaganda broadcast. That's the same one I fought on the way here, so I don't have to worry about that. All right, so to attack Toxic Alley from the east, you have to go through a building over here. But it does give you an improved vantage point. If you're attacking from the west, you're essentially attacking from the ground, and there are ways where enemies can be up higher off the ground, which, of course, puts you at a disadvantage, but this is what I'm talking about. You get to hang out up over here. And then the control point is actually this portion and then the inside this building over there. So I'm going to throw my turret down. Not really a good spot for it, unfortunately. Toss it over here. That looks fine. Off to a good start. Always got to keep an eye on it. See, make sure nobody's coming up behind you. Gotcha. All right. Can I throw a grenade? No. No, I can't make it that far. Shield guy. Man, drone is just taking care of the boss. Look at that. Drone's doing all the work. Drone MVP. From this side. Gotta get up here and spin around. Eat him. Oh, boss wave is coming from the other direction. Awesome. All right. That's fine, though. We got it in enough time. Who else? Is that it? Still something on the map. There they go. That level 16. All right. Another AK. I don't know that I would want to switch it out for my G36. Let's see if it's worth it. Oh, wow. Yeah, the bullets are considerably larger, but it's a way less accurate gun, so not gonna switch up for now. Let's see what my cash gives me. P416. Also a good assault rifle. Yeah, we'll switch up. What the hell? Custom skin. All right. Ability and whatever this gives me. Okay. Yeah, I got a bunch of loot. Apparently, been picking up all this crap, not even noticing. Let's see what we got. It's not a bad upgrade. That I will go. Fine. Same gloves, just higher level. Switch that out. Nope. No, thank you. Wow. All right, I'll switch. Jeez, just because it's so much higher. Okay. Actually, do that as primary. And we got a better pistol, so that's big deal. All right. Time for bank mission. Bank headquarters is where we save the president. The president's being held hostage by the hyenas. And Lulu just came back in, so let me go shut the door. And I'm back. All right. We should be able to get through this mission pretty quickly. A, it's not a very hard mission. And B, turret drone setup makes it even easier. So we'll be having a good time. The boss room, especially, I get to show off a little technique that I do, which makes it fun, particularly with a turret. And you can use different kinds of turrets if you want. All right, here we go. Not gonna matchmake. Same as usual. We're just gonna get this done. All right, for this first room, best to run up over here, post up on this area. Now, it is not good to have your turret next to you. The better place for your turret is up on this ledge. If you try to drop your turret where I'm taking cover, I think it falls through one of those situations. Terrain. Getting stuck. All right. Some cool artwork and stuff in this mission. I like it. Aim is getting worse as time goes on. It's all right, though. It just means there is a break in my future. Awesome. All right, it's a chest down here in this closet. As a Petrov chest. All right, I'll take it. Starting to see Petrov items, so the loot pool is slowly opening up. Warning, no respawn zone. Hey game, I'm playing hardcore mode. There's no such thing as respawn. All right. Enough with the joking. Didn't see that guy. Nice, nice, nice. Ooh, got a high end. And it's not an Emmeline's guard. Oh, it might be. Oh, it is. Never mind. It is an Emmeline's guard. Damn it. So, I'm in an awkward level for the loot pool. It wants to give me a high-end item, but there's very few high-end items at this level. That's why you see at the vendors, they sell this gun. I've gotten it dropped to me twice now. It's just one of the very few high-end items that are allowed at this low level. Which sucks, but it's fine. What am I... Okay, I've got 11 pips of armor. If I change to this, what do I have? 10 pips. All right, I'm fine. I don't need the Badger Tough gloves anymore. Okay. All right, there's a secret hidden switch here. Or a key. Opens up a door downstairs. There's also a lock on this bathroom. And there's a chest in here. SMG9. Yeah, the loot pool is undoubtedly opening up. I'm seeing a lot of things I have not been seeing up to this point, which is great news. 16, 17, it does start to open up. You do see your occasional high-end item, which is what I want. I want the yellow items. Blue and purple are okay, but the high-end items are the best. They come with talents, they come with mod slots, all the good stuff, all the things you want. Not that mods are going to do me much good. I mean, weapon mods, yes, but gear mods, skill mods, I'm going to be getting like 1% increase in stats, so don't care. But the talents on high ends, those do come in handy. So, and this room's very easy, by the way, so. Good that it went by fast, but it is a very fast room, no matter what. Although, to be fair, I have died in that room before. Not on hardcore, just normal gameplay. I have died in that room. We're doing great. Making good time here. But I did say this mission's really easy, so I've also done this mission a shitload of times. It's one of my favorites in this game, probably. Okay, that was the hidden key that we picked up upstairs. This is the door that it opens. There's also a key box in here, but again, I'm by myself, so I'm not going to bother opening it. Good to know that I do have two hyena keys, though. Not that I need them. And I'm going to switch level 12 up to a level 16 classic M60. Awesome. Now, the difference between the classic M60 and the others is the muzzle mod. There's no muzzle mod on the classic M60. But it does show up earlier in the loot pool. You can get a classic M60 at low level, very low level. So it's overall just a great gun, no matter what. All right. So this next bit, I gotta run and go hit a button on a laptop. There's no enemies in here yet, but they're gonna spawn from the doors behind me. So I'm gonna leave my turret here. I'm gonna go hit the button, and then I'm gonna try and run back and do just contain enemies, because I don't want them running throughout this room. There's way too much area to cover by myself. So I'm gonna try to bottleneck them where I threw my turret, essentially, and keep them limited to just that little area. And it makes this room go by so much faster. A bit harder when they throw a heavy gunner at you, but no problem. So, all right, so yeah, taking cover here, you can usually bottleneck the enemies pretty well. A little bit harder when you're by yourself, but that's why you bring a turret and a drone. Great. No complaints. Wow. I'm getting really lucky with my grenades today. Should have just left that enemy up so I didn't get another wave, but every wave is more opportunity for loot to drop, so hard to turn that down. Thanks, drone. At 10 seconds. I'm just gonna let the timer run out. I did get another wave. Okay, well, whatever. Not done yet. Oh, shit. For whatever reason, the pistols that the shield guys have are really powerful. So, I don't want to mess with them. Okay. Room over. Got a holster. Loot is the best. For sure. That's one of the best things about this game is the loot is plentiful and very fun to collect. I am not going to stand in the blast area this time. You can usually stand in the blast area of the C4 and it might not kill you, but because I'm hardcore, I don't want to risk it. Now, I will run through this fire because this fire will not kill you. So I'm okay with that. All right. Got one enemy in here. Dead. Okay. We got three rooms left. There is a chest in this bathroom. A lot of chests in bathrooms in this mission. For whatever reason. Somebody made it that way. Alright. So, in this room, I cannot let the president die. Not that I would want to. He is kind of annoying. And he does turn out to be the bad guy, or a bad guy. But that's no reason to let him get shot. At this stage, because you don't know that he's a bad guy yet. He hasn't technically become a bad guy yet. Awesome. All right. Now we have to escort him outside where a helicopter will come pick him up after I shoot a bunch more dudes. So that's going to be great. All right.
It's me.
Gotta wait for him to talk for a second.
Now.
Okay. Whenever you're ready.
Blow the damn roof off. Fine. Get me to the atrium.
All right. Here we go. Just this room and the boss room, and we'll be done. The president's taking some fire. Really want to take cover there, sir. Can't heal him if he does get shot, so. Alright, we're all done here. Just the boss room left, and I know how to do that. This is a cool thing that probably not very many people in this game do. So from here, so the boss will actually spawn down there where I'm shooting, which is a little bit off the ground. There's tons of enemies that'll spawn on the ground once I actually get down there. But if you're cool like me, you can leave your turret up here and have a nice vantage point for it to shoot everything in the room. So I always try to leave my turret up there when I'm using a turret on this particular mission. And then there are a couple of different areas you can post up down here. I prefer the left side of the room. There's a little alcove about halfway up over here. Gives you nice access. You are in a tiny amount of danger if the enemies rush you, but I'm not concerned right now. All right. Sniper down. There's going to be some snipers in the windows up there. There's one. But the turret's great for that too. Chilling over there. There's the boss. I gotta deal with the sniper and stuff. Come on, come on, come on. There we go. Okay. Did he just throw a grenade at me? The hell out of here. All right, boss is down. Another classic M60. All set. All right. See, easy mission. Easy peasy. Cool. All right. I go talk to Manny at the White House. Well, talk to Manny / President Ellis, because now that I've rescued him, He chills at the White House for a little bit of the story until you figure out he's evil and then a bunch of other stuff happens. Spoiler alert. Get a little more XP. We'll do our inventory management, and then I think I'm going to call it for the day. We're over 3 hours here. We're doing great. Almost about to hit level 17, so this is a perfect time. Oh, no, we did hit level 17. Thanks. Side mission. Collectible subset. Oh, I'm stuck in the doorway because I skipped a cutscene. Whenever you're done, you just let me know. So because I just hit 17, that means next time I do this, I can just start grabbing loot right away and check the vendors, just like I did when I started today, except I had to actually get to level 11, which took a tiny amount of effort. But now, I just hit 17. So, let's see what we got. Garbage. That's what we got. Absolute trash. All right, this gun is slightly better than that gun. Oh, it's because it's purple. Purple classic M60. Hey, it's got a bullshit talent on it, but that's okay. Ooh, all right. Moving right along. What else we got? Crap backpack, yep. And, ooh, better holster. All right. A lot of mods for no reason. Hang on to those. All right. Donation projects, yeah. Cool. Titanium and some backpacks. Cool. All right, we've donated everything we need to donate. We can sell all this. See, he's still only selling the Emmeline's Guard. Oh, that is tempting. That. Yep, I'm gonna buy that. Okay. So I have Companion, which is, that's gonna help a little bit. It's kind of a fun talent to use. I've got a two-piece Petrov bonus now, which gives me weapon handling, which is nice. And I've got 303 core stats, which I love. So next time on hardcore mode on this game, I'm going to be kicking some major ass. Definitely going to be doing the outcast missions, which are considerably tougher due to the suicide bombers and stuff. So we'll be having to do, let's see, going to have to get into this neighborhood, which doesn't have a mission. Going to have to go down and do Lincoln. Oh no, we gotta do DCD. That's it. That's level 18. Then we'll do Lincoln, which is level 20, which is against True Sons. Great mission, super fun. Then Potomac, which is 22, and Federal Emergency Bunker, which is 24. And that will be all of the base story missions. Then I'll have to start getting into the strongholds, which is District Union, and then there will be Capitol Building, and there will be, well, no. Capitol Building is last, sorry. District Union, then Roosevelt Island, then Capitol Building, then the whole thing changes because I'll have hit level 30 to do that. Once you hit level 30 and you clear Capitol Building, then the map becomes invaded and you got to start fighting Black Tusk, which they have some real high burst damage enemy archetypes like the Warhounds and the Johnny Fives and stuff. So that's when the game starts tuning up the difficulty a bit. Looks like I've got some more side missions to pick up. and different things at the campus, but I will worry about that next time. I think we did great today. I mean, there's no greens. There's no green items in my inventory. I got some purples. We got a lot of purples. Well, a couple purples, three purples. That's good. Blue's good. Purple's better. Yellow is the best. Until we get to max level, then we start getting reds and mint greens. All right. That's going to do it for me today. Once again, happy Thanksgiving, everybody. And I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day. Cheers, and I'll see you next time.